Android 13 is the latest major Android version released this year, and it comes with some behavioral changes that will force us to make some adaptations to our app to ensure it works properly. We already have at our disposal an informative document about these changes with links of interest to understand in more detail what they entail. However, in this video I want to take a more pragmatic approach through a simple example. What I'm going to present to you is an application running on Android 12. We're going to see what it does and what happens when we run it on Android 13. Once we have seen what happens, we will make the appropriate adjustments so that it works correctly on the latest version of Android. But first, a brief note. In this video, I'm going to focus basically on the changes related to reading files on disk and the new notification permission, since they are functionalities that the vast majority of applications have. You can see the rest of the changes in the official documentation. You can find the link in the video description. Our app will consist of the following: a floating button that, when pressed, will ask us for permission to read files. Once the permission is granted, we can choose a photo and it will be painted on the screen. Additionally, a notification will be displayed indicating that the photo has been uploaded correctly. We will use File Picker to be able to select files and Permission Handler to request the system permissions. To show notifications, we will use Flutter local notifications. Let's quickly see the code that composes this application. We first initialize the notifications using the Flutter local notifications plugin. We then launch our app encapsulated in the app widget. In our main screen, we have a state variable called FilePath, which will store the path to the chosen file. When the user clicks the button, the pickFile method will be called, which will take care of requesting permission to read files and will allow us to choose a file of type image. Once selected, the status is updated and the picture is displayed on the screen, and the postNotification method is called to publish the informative notification. This code snippet works correctly in versions before Android 13. If we run this app on a device with Android 13, we will see that it works more or less the same as before, except that now, once the image is selected, it asks us for permission to show notifications. Although the app continues to work, we have the problem that it is the system that is choosing the moment to ask for permission to show notifications, when ideally we should be the ones who decide when it is requested and if any explanatory text must be shown before. The problem is aggravated if we target Android 13. Now, when we press the floating button, we are not even asked for permission to read files. Why is this happening? Android 13 incorporates a granular permission system when it comes to reading files. While before it was enough to have the read external storage permission granted to read any file from external storage, now we will have to specifically define what type of files we intend to read. In this app, we want to read images, so we will ask for the read media images permission. If we wanted to read videos, we will ask for read media video, and if we wanted audio files, we will have read media audio. Let's make the following adjustments to the Android manifest file to resolve this issue. Through this change, we are indicating to the system that for Android 12 or lower, we continue to depend on read external storage, while from Android 13, we will use the new granular permission system. Other change that Android 13 brings is the need to have explicit permission from the user to display notifications, as has been the case in iOS for a long time. Let's declare that permission in Android manifest. Install the Device Info Plus plugin. This plugin will help us to know what version of Android is running, and consequently we will know what set of permissions to request. Now, modify pickFile as follows. If the version is Android 12 or lower, we ask for the storage permission. Otherwise, we ask for the new image and notification permission. And with this last change, we can now choose an image. It is displayed on the screen and the informative notification is also shown. In this video, I have made a simple review of two of the behavioral changes that Android 13 incorporates: the new granular permission system for reading files and the new permission to be able to show notifications. In addition to these two, I recommend that you read the official documentation to see these changes in more detail, as well as to see the rest of the changes that this version of Android incorporates, since they may affect the operation of your application. Please like the video if you found it useful and consider subscribing for more content related to Flutter and app development. Thank you for watching and have a nice rest of your day.